Israel. Today, President Obama and other world leaders gather in Russia for the G20 summit. Syria is not officially on the agenda, but it's expected to dominate discussions. And back home, debate continues on whether the U.S. should intervene.
A tense moment for President Obama today as he faces off with Russian President Vladimir Putin. Putin backs the Assad regime and says the U.S. is lying about Syria's use of chemical weapons. He's warned President Obama not to take action in Syria without U.N. approval.
Only the U.N. Security Council could sanction the use of force against a sovereign state.
But the U.S. moves forward with its plans to punish Syria. President Obama monitoring the votes of lawmakers here at home and calling for a strong international response. At the same time, he's also trying to step back from his red line declaration that started him on the path to a U.S. strike.
I didn't set a red line. The world set a red line. The world set a red line when governments representing 98% of the world's population said the use of chemical weapons are abhorrent and passed a treaty forbidding their use even when countries are engaged in war.
Back in Washington, the Senate Foreign Relations Committee passed a resolution that would give the president the authority to strike Syria. But it's still unclear whether it can pass the full Senate or House. Wednesday, Secretary of State John Kerry tried to convince House members to vote yes.
The world is wondering whether the United States of America is going to consent through silence to stand aside while this kind of brutality is allowed to happen without consequence.
But some say it's already too late. Conservative writer John Fund slammed Obama for his, quote, pattern of indecisiveness. Fund wrote in National Review Online, Washington is abuzz with talk about how much President Obama has damaged America's credibility with his indecisiveness on Syria. Meanwhile, skepticism is still coming from both Democrats and Republicans.
I don't believe that we should have given up so easily on using the United Nations.
We haven't given
using
up.
Us. Yes, we have.
I see a horrible tragedy, but I don't see that our involvement will lessen the tragedy.
Meanwhile, in Syria, the brutal fighting continues. Al-Qaeda-linked rebels attacked a Christian village held by the Assad regime.